Hands down, StreamYard is one of the best tools that you can use when it comes to live streaming, because they make live streaming so, so easy. Whether that's, you know, bringing on a guest to interview, doing transitions in real time between your interviewer or even your slides, as well as being able to brand your live streams with backgrounds, thirds, and things like that. Another cool tool when it comes to live streaming is the Elgato Stream Deck, which is a device that allows you to customize it so that at a push of a button when you're doing live streams, you can make something happen. And when you pair StreamYard with the Stream Deck, you get awesome things. And so that's why in this video, I'm gonna be showing you how you can set up the Stream Deck with your StreamYard. So let's get into it.
You gotta just press record.
Hey, what's up? It's Omar Tsukori with Think Media, and shout out to StreamYard for sponsoring this video. And we personally love using StreamYard here at Think Media. We use it to do all our live streams, whether it's on our YouTube channel, Think Media, or even our Think Media podcast, as well as our private Facebook groups with our communities and students. And so if you wanna check out StreamYard, be sure to check out the link down in the description below. But if you're watching this, you may already have StreamYard. And I would say if you don't already have the Elgato Stream Deck, that's okay. You can actually use your keyboard in the same way, and I'll show you how to do that as well. But the Elgato Stream Deck is a fantastic device that comes in three different sizes, whether that's 6 buttons, 15, or 32 buttons. Personally, I have the 15. But if you want a smaller footprint on your desk, maybe you want the 6-button one, but we'll post links to it down in the description below. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is log into StreamYard and open it up. Select the gear icon at the bottom of the screen. Upon pressing the gear icon, you could see on the left side that you have the options of hotkeys. Now, when you click on that, you can actually see all the various things that you can customize now with your current keyboard, which is super cool. And if you've never seen this before, there's gonna be a default setting to those, but you can totally 100% customize them to how you would want to customize them. However, to set this up with the Stream Deck the fastest way possible, the second thing you're gonna wanna do is download the StreamYard profile for the Elgato Stream Deck, and we'll post a link to that down in the description below so you can go straight to it. And then once you have downloaded the StreamYard profile, just open up your Stream Deck's configuration and then double click the StreamYard profile, and then it'll auto populate on your Stream Deck. This is a super easy way to now transition to and from certain looks and dynamics while you're conducting a live stream on StreamYard. However, you could still move it around on the Stream Deck itself based off of what you'd like, which you can do in your Stream Deck configuration and make something maybe more simpler or even create your own, which is one thing I love about the Stream Deck is that you can actually create your own little button icons. But all that to say, the StreamYard default does just fine. And then the last step slash tip that I would give you is to actually just do a practice run. You know, once you go live, you're live. But now that you have the hotkeys, to definitely just know where they're at. The whole point of having hotkeys is that you necessarily don't even need to look, or you can use your peripherals to actually conduct the transition or start or end your live stream and things like that. And so just conduct a practice live stream. And if you actually wanna check out my 2-angle live stream setup that I have going on kind of behind me right here, this is my desk setup. It's super fresh, super cool. You can click or tap the screen to check that out. And I can't wait to see you in a future video. Peace.